Hello students, in this video we will be solving the further questions of exercise 2.2. So from question number 9 we will solve the question. So here is question number 9. It is tan inverse x upon a square minus x square. We have to solve this question and we have to find the answer. Okay, so for that what we need to let is, here is a constant term a. Okay, we need to solve the question in term of x because it is given that mod of x is greater than a. Okay, so it is greater than a, then we can say that this a square, and if we let x square to some value, that will give us 10. Okay, so in term of let a is equals to, x is equals to a sine theta. Okay, if we let x is equals to a sine theta, so from here we will have x upon a is equals to sine theta, and theta is equals to sine inverse x upon a. Okay, because at last we will get the value in terms of theta and we have to convert that, so we have converted it previously. Okay, so now this question will become then tan inverse x is a sine theta, and in denominator a square as it is, and x square, up x is a sine theta, then x square will be a square sine square theta. Okay, so from here we will have tan inverse a sine theta upon a square can be taken as common. So from here we have 1 minus this is sine square theta, and we know that sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. Okay, so now this will become tan inverse a sine theta upon, look, this can be written as a square cos square theta, because if we, this will become cos square theta is equals to 1 minus sine square theta. Okay, these are the identities that you always have to keep in your mind. So from here we have tan inverse a sine theta upon, this a square will become a, and cos square theta will become cos theta. From here these two parts a will cancel out, and this will give us the value tan inverse tan theta, because sine theta upon cos theta is equals to tan theta, and this you have to mention. Okay, cos theta is equals to tan theta. So now here we have the value, what we have the value as theta, and the theta is equals to sine inverse x upon a. This is our answer. Okay, so in this manner we have to solve the value. And here is one trick to solve these kind of question. Whenever we have to solve the question in terms of x, and there is another constant, there is another constant given in the question, like here a constant is term a. Okay, so we have to let the value with a. Here we have let it the x is equals to a sine theta. Okay, so from here a is taken as common out. Look, in place of x there is a sine theta. Okay, so we have to cut this a part, and in denominator this is a square. Okay, so this is taken as common out, and as we remove the root from here we have a cos theta. A and a can be cancelled out, and from sine upon cos gives us the value tan theta. From here we have theta is equals to sine inverse x upon a. Okay, now let's do another question. This is question number 10. Okay, we will try to solve maximum questions in this video. So here is our question number 10 in this video. Look, this is something like, if we put x is equals to tan theta, then this will become 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta upon 1 minus tan cube theta, something like this. Okay, so we have to make it first as here it will be tan theta. Okay, and here also this will become tan cube theta. Okay, so for that we have to let x is equals to a tan theta, because we know that tan 3 theta is equals to 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta upon 1 minus 3 tan theta. Okay, so from here we have x is equals to a tan theta, then this will become tan inverse 3 a square as it is. And in place of x we have, look, from here also find the value of theta. So this will be x upon a is equals to tan theta. And from here we have theta is equals to tan inverse x upon a. Okay. Now we move to the question, and the question will become here, it will be a tan theta. Okay, minus x cube will be a cube tan cube theta, okay, divided by a cube. So a cube as it is, and 3a into x square will become a square tan square theta. Okay, now from here we have, look, a square into a will give us a cube. And tan theta as it is, so tan theta minus, this will become same as it is already written, a cube tan cube theta. Now in denominator, a cube minus this a square and a can be written as 3a cube tan square theta. Okay, so now we have the, look, in above part and denominator part, we can take a cube as common. So in numerator it will become 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta. Okay, and in denominator if we take a cube as common, this will become 1 minus 3 tan square theta. Okay, so a cube and a cube will be cancel out, and from here we have the value 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta upon 1 minus 3 tan square theta. Okay, and we know that this is the identity of tan 3 theta. So here we can write, in place of this identity, we can write tan 3 theta. Okay, now we have to check it for whether 3 theta lies between minus a upon root 3 to a upon root 3. Okay, now we have to check it for theta. Okay, and theta x is equals to a tan theta. Here a tan theta must be lies between minus a upon root 3 to a upon root 3. Okay, so if we cancel out a from all parts, all three parts, here we have the value 1 upon root 3 tan theta less than 1 upon root 3. This is minus 1 upon root 3, this is plus 1 upon root 3. So from here we have the value theta will be equals to, look, this value can be written as 1 by 3 is the value of 10, 30 or 60. 10, 30. Okay, so this is the value of minus pi by 3 and here plus pi by 3. Now if we multiply 3 to both sides, we have the value minus pi 3 theta and it is positive pi. So 3 theta is lying between minus pi to plus pi. Okay, so here we can write as 3 theta because this is the range in between this. Okay, it lies between this, so 3 theta, and we know that theta is equals to tan inverse x upon a. So this is our answer, 3 tan inverse x upon a. Okay, let's move to another question, question number 11. In this question it is said that tan inverse 2 cos 2 sine inverse 1 by 2. Okay, so we know that sine inverse sine x is equals to x when x lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. These are the ranges. Okay, so here 1 by 2 is the value of pi by 3. साइन पाई बाय थ्री, एंड पाई बाय थ्री लाइज बिटवीन पाई बाय माइनस पाई बाय टू टू पाई बाय टू. ओके, दिस इज पाई बाय टू, दिस इज माइनस पाई बाय टू. ओके, सो दिस वैल्यू पाई बाय थ्री इज 60 डिग्री, सो समथिंग लाइक दिस. इट विल लाई हेयर इन बिटवीन दिस. सो हेयर वी कैन राइट दिस फॉर्म एज 2 cos 2 sin inverse sin pi by 3. Okay. So from here, now we can write this value as tan inverse 2 cos 2 sin inverse sin pi by 3 can be written as 2 pi by 3. Okay. This. Okay, so now from here we have this 2 can be multiplied to this tan inverse 2 cos 2 pi by 3. Okay, so now we have, look, 2 pi by 3 can be written as pi minus pi by 3. Okay, since cos pi minus pi by 3 is equals to cos pi by 3, because minus cos pi by 3. Okay, sorry, 1 by 2, it is the value of pi by 6 sine 30 degree. Okay, 30 degree can be written as, so this will become pi by 6 will become pi by 3. Okay, this 2 and 6 can be cancelled out. From here, we have the value tan inverse 2 cos pi by 3. And we know that the value of 2 cos pi by 3, the value of cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2. Cos 60 degree is 1 by 2. So these two will be cancelled out. From here we have tan inverse 1. Okay. And 1 can be written as tan inverse 10 pi by 4. So from here we have the value pi by 4 is our answer. Okay. It looks like a little mesh, but let us overview again. So here sine inverse sine x is equals to x. We know that 1 by 2 can be written as pi by 6. So from here we have the value, this 2 is in multiplied 2 into pi by 6. This will give us the value tan inverse 2 cos pi by 3. Okay, then this pi by 3, the cos pi by 3, value of cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2. Cos 60 degree is 1 by 2. So 2 and 2 can be cancelled out. This gave us the value tan inverse 1. Okay. And this 1 is the value of tan pi by 4. Tan 45 degree is equals to 1. So from here we have pi by 4 is our answer. Okay. Now question number 13. Okay. In question number 12, it is simply given that tan inverse x plus cot inverse y, this is the identity, it is equals to pi by 2. Okay, then cot pi by 2 will be 0. So 0 is our answer. So question number 13, in this question, look, this is the identity. Look at the property number 6, property 6 of properties of inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, these are the identities that is already given in your NCERT book. So this identity, look, first I write tan 1 by 2. Look, this 1 by 2 is in multiply. Okay, so tan 1 by 2, here sine inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square is the identity of 2 tan inverse x. Okay, and plus cos inverse 1 minus y square upon 1 plus y square, this is in the term of y, so it is the identity of tan inverse y. Okay, here you can mention, since 2 tan inverse x is equals to sin inverse 2x upon 1 plus x square, and since 2 tan inverse x is equals to cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square. Okay, but here it is given in the term of y, so this identity will become in terms of y. Okay, now we will solve it for identity, that is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. Look, From here, 2 can be taken as common, 1 by 2 into 2. So this will become tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. Okay, 2 and 2 will be cancelled out. So from here we have tan inverse, look, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Okay, this is the identity. Here we have to see that xy is less than 1. Okay, we have a condition that when we found the value, the multiply the product of xy must be less than 1. Okay, so from here we have tan inverse is equals to tan inverse. So from here we have x plus y upon 1 minus xy. This is our answer. Okay, in terms of x and y. Now, in question number 14, a simple identity is given, sine inverse 1 by 5 plus cos inverse x. This is our question number 14, sine inverse 1 by 5 plus cos inverse x is equals to 1. Okay, so this can be written as sine inverse 1 by 5 plus cos inverse x is equals to sine inverse 1, and 1 can be written as sine pi by 2. So from here we have the value sine inverse 1 by 5 is equals to pi by 2. This can be transferred to that side, minus cos inverse x. Okay, and then apply the identity sine inverse x plus cos inverse x is equals to pi by 2. Okay, so by this you can solve. Now, question number 15, in this question, we just simply have to put, look, this is total x, this is the value of y. So since we know that tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equals to tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy, when xy is less than 1, this is the identity for plus. Okay, so here we have x and y. So here we can write this as tan inverse. Look, x is the entire this value, x minus 1 upon x minus 2. Okay, plus y is x plus 1 upon x plus 2. Okay, divided by 1 minus xy, that is x minus 1 upon x minus 2 into x plus 1 upon x plus 2. Okay, this is the value. Now, since we know that a plus b into a minus b is equals to a square minus b square. Okay, so from here we have tan inverse. So look, from here if we take LCM of x minus 2 and x plus 2, this x plus 2 will be multiplied here. This will become x plus 2 into x minus 1. And from here x plus 2 will cancel out, and here positive sign, x minus 2 into x plus 1. Okay, LCM. And in denominator, look, this is a square minus b square. Okay, so here, look, first write as it is. It is x minus 2 and x plus 2. Okay, so above here, in place of 1, it will become x plus 2 into x minus 2 minus, here it is x minus 1 into x plus 1. Okay, now, if we solve this, look, these two denominator part will cancel each other. So from here we have the value x plus 2 into x minus 1. Okay, look, also write it is equals to pi by 4. Okay, equals to pi by 4. So we will transfer this 10 to another side. So this will become 10 pi by 4. Okay, and to LHS we have x plus 2 into x minus 1. This will give us x square minus x plus 2x minus 2. This is plus sign, so plus as it is, x into x, x square, x into 1, plus x, minus 2 into x, minus 2x, minus 2 into plus 1, minus 2. Okay, and in denominator, look, this is the identity of a plus b, a minus b. So a square minus b square, that is 4. And this is minus sign. From here, we have x square minus b square, a square minus b square. So this will give us a square. Look, if we remove this minus sign from here, we have x square minus 1. So this minus 1 will become plus 1. Okay, so now 10 pi by 4 is equals to 1. From here, x square plus x square, this is 2x square. Okay, minus x plus 2x, this is plus x and plus x. Look, minus 2x plus 2x will cancel out, minus x and plus x will cancel each other. Okay, so from here we have 2x square, minus 2 and minus 2 is minus 4. And in denominator we have x square minus x square will cancel each other. And minus 4 plus 1, this gave us minus 3. Okay, so from here we have 2x square minus 4 is equals to minus 3. This will transfer to that side. And from here we have 2x square is equals to minus 3 plus 4. And 2x square is equals to 1. Then x square is equals to 1 by 2. Then the value of x is equals to 1 upon root 2. This is our answer. Okay. Now let's solve question number 16. In this question, look, sine x inverse sine x is equals to x whenever the value of sine x, means x lies between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Okay, so 2 pi by 3, this will give us the value pi is 180 divided by 360. This will give us the value sine 120 degree, and 120 degree lies in third quadrant, and this is the range for sine x to be x. So here we can write this sine inverse sine pi minus pi by 3. Can we write it as this? Okay, because 2 by 2 pi by 3 does not lies in this part, in the range of sine x. Okay, because sine x ranges minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. This is 0, this is pi by 2, this is pi, this is minus pi by 2. Okay, so from here to, and 2 pi by 3 lies in third quadrant. Okay, so for that, to become this part x, we need the x lies between this quadrant. Okay, so from here we will have sine inverse, look, sine 180 minus theta is equals to sine theta, because in second quadrant sine and cosec is positive and the value does not change for 180 degree. Okay, so here we have sine pi by 3. So from here we have the answer pi by 3. Okay, in the same way this question, like the value of tan inverse 10x is equals to x whenever x belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, this is the range for tan theta. Okay, so here 3 pi by 4 will lie somewhere 135 degree. It also lies in quadrant third. Okay, so from here we will write this as tan inverse 10 pi minus pi by 4. Okay, so from here we have 180 minus theta. Okay, so here, look, this value lies in second quadrant, 180 minus theta lies in second quadrant. So here, since tan 180 minus theta, look, in second quadrant only sine and cos is positive. Oh, sine and cosec is positive. So this will give us minus 10 theta. Okay, this will give us the value tan inverse 10 minus pi by 4. Okay, and this minus pi by 4 can be written as, since we know that tan minus theta is equals to minus 10 theta. Okay, because only cos minus theta and sec minus theta is positive cos theta or positive sec theta. So this will give us the value in place of 10 minus theta. We can write minus 10 theta. So minus will be out, and from here we have 10 inverse 10 pi by 4. And this will give us the value minus pi by 4 is our answer. Okay, now let's do another question. This is question number 18 and also the last question that we will discuss in this video, because remaining questions is going to be solved in this way only. Okay, and they are very easy questions. So here we have 10. Look, this is sine inverse 3 by 5 plus cot inverse 3 by 2. Okay, we know that 1 upon 10 is equals to cot. Okay, so 1 upon 10 inverse also equals to cot inverse. So this cot inverse can be written as, look, first of all, if we take a right angled triangle, okay, then sine is equals to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Okay, so hypotenuse is 5, perpendicular is 3. Okay, so by Pythagoras theorem, its base will be 4. Okay, and if we want to make it in the form of 10, because here 10 is given, so this will become 10 inverse, and 10 is equals to perpendicular upon base. So here perpendicular is 3 and base is 4. 10 inverse 3 by 4, okay, plus cot inverse can be written as 10 inverse, and these value will flip each other, that is 2 by 3. Okay, and now we know that since 10 inverse x plus 10 inverse y is equals to 10 inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy, where xy must be less than 1. So here we will check it for x into y, 3 by 4 into 2 by 3. So this will give us 3, 1 upon 2. And 1 upon 2 is less than 1. Half is less than 1. So we can apply this formula. So here we can write 10 inverse x plus y. This is 3 by 4 plus 2 by 3 upon 1 minus 3 by 4 into 2 by 3. Okay. So from here we will be having the value. First of all, take the LCM of 3 and 4. This will give us the value 12. And from here we have 9, and from here we have 8, okay, divided by 3 4s are 12, so LCM will be 12 minus 3 2s are 6, okay. So now this will give us 10 inverse, look, 9 plus 8 is 17 upon 12 into 12 upon 12 minus 6, 6. So these two will cancel out. This will give us 10 into 10 inverse 17 upon 6. Okay. So from here we have the value 17 upon 6 as our answer. Okay.